Hey, what's up guys, this is Vimal here and welcome back to TRHD. Today I have an awesome new product to show you. It's a cheap 3-axis gimbal for DSLRs. A lot of you guys have been asking me to make a video on a budget gimbal for DSLRs around 10,000 rupees. So today here I am with a product in that price range. Now this is a manual gimbal guys. This gimbal is very big in size and comes in this huge bag. The quality of the carry bag is good and it's really heavy. It is very different from those electronic ones which I have shown you till now. This gimbal is made by CamGear and the model is FlowCam DGS. It's a quick balancing camera stabilizer and comes with the dovetail quick release plate. I'm quite excited to check it out. Let's get started. I want to thank CamGear for sending me this product for review purpose. So here it is. The FlowCam DGS stabilizer comes like this. Looks like we've got a manual here. It has the complete info on the product including how to assemble and the procedure to use it. Make sure to read it. We'll just keep it aside for now and check out the FlowCam. So here is the FlowCam DGS camera stabilizer. It comes in 3 parts. You need to assemble it before using. Let me show you all the parts. This is the head. It's the main platform where you mount the camera. It's quite heavy, fully made of metal. And as you can see, it comes with the dovetail quick release plate at the top. Let me just take it out and show you. This is how it looks like. It's made of metal, has rubber grip at the top, and also has a scale on the left side. This quick release plate is very useful. You can fix it to the camera and easily mount and dismount from the gimbal. This head also has front to back and side to side adjustment knobs for fine tuning and perfect balancing. So that was about the camera mounting platform. Now let me show you the actual gimbal assembly. This is the main part of the stabilizer. It lets you control the movement of the gimbal with the help of this handle. Even this whole thing is made of metal. The build quality is good. It's a 3-axis gimbal. And talking about the movements feel buttery smooth, there is no friction. The handle has a rubber grip, so you can hold it comfortably. You've got the CamGear branding here, and the model is FlowCam DGS. This stand can be extended up to 81 cm in height. You've got a scale on it as well, and it's hollow from the inside. And the final main part you have in the bag is the base platform of the gimbal. This thing has 16 counterweight plates on it to maintain the dynamic balance in the gimbal. Each plate weighs around 110 grams, so the total weight of this base platform is more than 1.7 kgs. You need to remove or add the counterweight plates depending on the weight of your camera. For smaller DSLRs weighing around 500 grams, you don't need all these 16 plates. 2 or 3 pair would be more than enough. The gimbal assembly fixes at the center, and these knobs can be adjusted to extend the base for precise balancing. The construction of the base platform is solid. So these were the 3 main parts of the gimbal. Along with that, you also get few accessories like extra screws, mounts, and an Allen key. So these are all the items you got in the package. Now I'll show you how to assemble the FlowCam and the balancing procedure. So let's get started with the assembling. Here's the gimbal head. This is where you'll be mounting your camera. It has to be fixed on top of the central post. This is the main gimbal assembly, or also called a central post. It has a handle to hold and control the movements. And this is called the base platform, on which the whole gimbal is fixed. So the first thing you need to do is take the central post and fix it on the base platform. The base platform has a threaded stud at the center. Just take the central post. You should be holding it like this. Now put it on top of the stud and start screwing it. Make sure to screw it tightly. There you go, that's done. The gimbal will look like this now. The central post can also be extended. You have a lever at the bottom for that. You need to loosen it up to extend it. It can be extended up to 81 cm in height depending on your use. Now the handle's position can also be adjusted. It is very easy to do that. You just need to loosen it up to adjust the position. You need to adjust and fix the handle in a position such that you get a drop time of about 2 to 3 seconds. It also has a scale over here. After fixing the central post on the base, you need to fix this mounting head on top of it. It is very easy to fix it. Just place it on the top and push it inside the post. Now fix it to the post with the help of the given 2 screws. Tighten the screws and you're all done with the assembling. The gimbal is ready to be used. I'll show you how to fix the camera on it. I'll be using my Panasonic G7. I just bought it recently. So the first thing you need to do is remove this quick release plate from the head and fix it to your camera. This is how it'll look like. The camera on the quick release plate can be placed according to the size of the lens. The position can be changed with the help of this quarter inch screw at the bottom. Now take the camera and slide it on top of the head, just like this. To lock the camera on the gimbal, you've got a lever on the right side. Tighten it up to fix it firmly. You're all done with the setup, guys. Now you need to balance the camera. For balancing compact DSLR cameras or mirrorless cameras, you don't need to use all the 16 counterweight plates on the base platform. I'm just using 2 pair of plates for my camera. If you use bigger cameras, then you can add more weights. Remove these plates like this. It's very easy to remove them. Just unscrew these 2 nuts, remove the excess weight, and screw them back properly. Do the same on the other side. Now that the excess weight is removed, we are ready to fix the camera on the gimbal and balance it for the right drop time, which is around 2 to 3 seconds. While balancing, if you feel the camera is wobbling on its pan axis, then you can adjust the base plate length using these 2 knobs to minimize that wobble. So this is how it looks when the gimbal is completely assembled and the camera is fixed on it. I've already balanced the gimbal. You can see that it's quite stable and the movements look smooth. It has 360 degree pan axis rotation. There is no wobble in it. Spins really smooth. Let me also show you the drop time. It's around 2.5 seconds, which is pretty good. When using these type of manual gimbals, you have to maintain the drop time of around 2 to 3 seconds by balancing it. Otherwise, you may not get the expected smooth and steady footage when shot on this gimbal. There's a lot of technique involved in using these manual gimbals. It is not that easy as you think. You need to have a lot of practice to use it properly. And this is the way to hold this gimbal. You should hold the gimbal's handle in one hand, and the other hand should only be used to give slight support to the movements of the gimbal, like how I am doing in this video. You should never hold the gimbal with the other hand firmly, as you may end up spoiling the smooth gimbal movements. So that was how you balance and use these manual gimbals. Now let's go out and shoot some samples. This video was shot on my Panasonic G7 using the FlowCam gimbal. It was shot in 1080p60. I have not changed the frame rate because I wanted to show you the actual movements and performance of the FlowCam. The video feels quite smooth and steady. One thing I've noticed when using this gimbal is, the footage looks more natural and has cinematic movements in it. You can shoot some awesome 360 degree cinematic shots with this manual gimbal, which is very difficult to do using electronic gimbals. Also, when you need to shoot some fast action scenes, then electronic gimbals are not much preferable. You need to use these manual gimbals to get that cinematic feel. This is the way you need to hold and walk while shooting with these type of gimbals. Here's the video that I shot on it. The FlowCam DGS was doing a good job. The videos shot on it were smooth and quite steady. Now you shouldn't compare it with an electronic gimbal. It's not a fair comparison. Both are made for different use. I'll also be making a special video on the comparison between these two type of gimbals so that you can clearly understand which gimbal to be used according to your purpose. For the price you're paying, it was doing a good job. It can take a max payload of 5.5 kgs, which is very high compared to an electronic stabilizer. And one more thing, guys, these manual gimbals don't need any power to run. You can keep on going as long as your body can take. They feel quite heavy and you may get tired after some time. I suggest you to pre-plan your shots so you don't get tired at the right moment. So that was my video on the FlowCam DGS manual gimbal. It's a good gimbal for the price. The build quality is nice, the performance is good, you can get smooth cinematic shots with it, but the only thing is, you need a lot of practice to use it. Don't expect you'll get awesome steady shots right out of the box. You need to spend some time practicing with it, then you'll be able to shoot some good videos. It costs about 10,600 rupees. It's available on Amazon India. I'll just leave a link to that in the description box below. You can check it out there. So that was it for today. Thanks for watching this video. Make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more new awesome videos. And I'll see you in the next one.